How are you?
Very good. How about you?
I'm fine, thanks. So it's a pleasure to have you back on the show, especially at such an exciting time where you are basically on the brink of a whole new phase with for Cardano, with Shelley. You decided to take on this challenge with Chico Crypto about this fight of 2020. Why did you issue that challenge?
Well, you know, so 2020 is all about adoption of Cardano. I spent all these years in the damn lab. We've written 53 papers. We've done lots of science, lots of engineering, and more is not better. It's like if you're starving, if I give you a loaf of bread, you're very happy. If I give you a second loaf of bread, you say, okay, that's okay. If I give you a third
avocado.
I don't want it anymore, right? So it's the same situation. We're not going to win in 2020 by just doing more science and more engineering. You know, that's we're doing that, but that's not the focus. The focus is adoption. And if we want this to be a platform for a billion people, we have to cast a really big tent. And part of that is the sports world. Part of that is basically building out infrastructure so people can build prediction markets of who's going to win, which team. People can bet on things. People can do all kinds of things around that sport. So what I was looking for was some form of an event that was very polarizing. It would really engage a lot of people that don't like me and love me to basically get into a debate and encourage the development of infrastructure on Cardano, everything from prediction markets of who's going to win to being able to bet on who's going to win, these types of things for third-party developers. And it has basically a date. You have to get it done by that fight, and there's an incentive for people to participate. Now, the reason why I challenged Chico is he's been an extremely harsh critic of not only Cardano, but of many other projects. So a lot of people really just hate the guy and would love to see him get his ass kicked. So I figured, wow, this would be a fun fight to go and do.
How are you going to train?
Here's the thing. So I do everything systematically because I'm a mathematician by training. So the first thing you do is you negotiate. So I went to Jason, who's a friend of mine, a Crypto Crow, and he was an MMA promoter for 6 years. Huge guy, 7 feet tall. And yeah. They called him the Tower of Pain when he was fighting. And I said, all right, Jason, basically be the bridge. Go talk to Chico, get his email. Let's get an NDA set up and negotiate a fight. So Jason reaches out to him, and Chico refused to even talk to our guys. So apparently he wants to do all the fight negotiations in public over Twitter and Reddit, which is just not how it's done. Everything has to be done by his terms or else he won't do it at all. So yesterday we said, look, we're just not going to do that. So I'm happy to fight somebody next year. And I have lots of great people to train me, and we can make a lot of fun out of it. But it doesn't look like the Chico fight is going to happen because he's just not really willing to be an adult or be reasonable.
Well, I think at this point, many people, they say, you know, let's do that. When it comes to the time,
right.
Because
there's a business side to this. I mean, I would have to put up front probably around $50,000 just to get everything set up, the licenses set up. We'd have to have a fight contract. It would have to be regulated by one of the commissions. We already reached out to the Ohio Commission and talked to them about an exhibition match. So there's a lot of logistics there, and both parties have to actually have a direct line of communication and negotiate, and there has to be consequences if one of the parties acts in bad faith. For example, I wouldn't want a situation where I put up $50,000, set everything up, did all the marketing, and the day before he backs out with no consequence. So he wasn't even willing to even have an email conversation with us to negotiate.
But listen, how about, this sports stuff is really interesting. I mean, I would fight with you, but I think that'd be unfair. I thought, why we don't do you don't think maybe doing something else that is not fighting and is maybe a marathon or is maybe another kind of competitive sport that can get different people involved,
right?
And that might be an idea, because find somebody that wants to fight with you is kind of like, well, then we have to fight. So I might get injured, and then you need an insurance. It creates a little bit more problem, and it's still one-to-one anyway. I don't know. I'm just saying. I
thought and we will do something like that. Maybe a competitive chess match or, you know, something. Yeah. But we'll figure something out for 2020. And the point is, it has to be polarizing, and there has to be strong opinions on both sides, and really create incentives for people to want to get involved and want to watch.
Right, gotcha.
And so we'll figure that out. And, but you know, the fight was kind of a fun idea, but you know, I'm kind of sad that we couldn't even get negotiations started, because I was fully prepared to go and train. We even reached out to Brock Lesnar's people, and we have great Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and Muay Thai people here in Colorado. They trained the Olympics here.
Oh.
And It would have been great. I would have lost 30 pounds and, you know, really.
Yeah, but listen, would you have gone to maybe train like Kung Fu or martial arts as well?
Yeah. Muay Thai is Thai kickboxing. And it's great for this stuff because you get the striking power. And Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is like all the ground game. So it's brutal stuff. And I had people lined up and I was ready to go. I'm already training to go to Antarctica, actually, in March. I'm going to go climb Mount Terror, and I'm going with the Iceman. So wow. we're gonna go and climb shirtless this volcano in Antarctica in the freezing cold. So I've already been, you know, preparing for that stuff, and I figure I could just couple some of that training with the Vike loss. It's his loss. I mean, it was a super high profile event. I don't need anything to make myself famous. I'm doing pretty good in the cryptocurrency space, but he lives and dies by views of his YouTube page. And if, you know, by passing, all he's doing is hurting his own brand and reputation and his own show. And it just shows you who he is. So, for example, he made all these videos about how bad ADA is and it's a scam, but then he wanted to be paid in ADA to fight. So let me get this straight. We're a scam coin and we're worthless, but then you want to be compensated in the same token you say is worth nothing. It already served its purpose. It kind of just showed the people who this guy is. And I'm sad we don't get to have some fun with it, but you know, we'll find something else in August.
Yeah, we find somebody else. Maybe we'll be Binance.
Yeah, well, actually, Roger Ver would be the one to fight, but he'd kick my ass because he's like a black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and okay. Roger's a super disciplined guy. But I like Roger a lot. It would be a lot of fun to do something with him.
Okay, Charles. So it was really great to talk to you.
This was so much fun. Thank you so much for hosting me.
Yeah, it was really fun, actually. It was much fun than the other time. Okay, Charles, I wish you all the best, and thank you very much.
Cheers.